Now let's cover the WWC's training program, the logistics of how to complete the training, and for those who are interested, how to pursue the optional reviewer certification. The WWC offers three online trainings and corresponding certifications. This training, the group design training, describes how to apply the WWC standards to RCTs and quasi-experimental designs, also known as QEDs. The Advanced Group Design Training describes how to apply the WWC's standards to regression discontinuity design studies and designs that include complier average causal effects. Finally, the Single Case Design Training describes how to apply the WWC's standards to single case designs. This training series covers the WWC's procedures and standards for reviewing evidence from group design studies. The WWC's group design standards are used when reviewing evidence from studies that use randomized controlled trial designs, or RCTs, including those using individual level or cluster level assignment to conditions. The WWC's group design standards are also used when reviewing evidence from studies that use quasi-experimental designs, or QEDs. This group design standards training is appropriate for those interested in assessing the credibility of research evidence on the effectiveness of education interventions and those interested in interpreting research findings. This may include researchers who are developing rigorous studies that will meet WWC group design standards. This training is appropriate for those interested in becoming WWC certified reviewers in the group design standards, as well as individuals interested in becoming certified in advanced group designs or single case designs, because group design certification is a prerequisite for either certification. We recommend that you proceed sequentially through the modules in this training series because later modules revisit and build upon the concepts taught in earlier modules. Thus, you should continue to Chapter 1 of Module 2 after completing this introductory module. After completing a chapter or module, you can use the button in the middle of the screen to continue moving through the training, or use the menu on the left to navigate through the modules. You can also download and print the slides from each module to view offline. We encourage you to take your time with the training and not complete it in one sitting. You can return to the training or start any module at any time by using the table of contents. There are several resources available to you to supplement your learning during this training. The WWC Procedures and Standards Handbook is a key resource. The handbook documents all of the procedures and standards discussed in this training and include information about how the WWC reviews, documents, and reports on studies. Throughout the training, we will direct you to the handbook to learn more about a particular topic. You should also consult the Study Review Protocol. It guides the reviews of all studies reviewed under WWC Procedures and Standards Handbook version 5.0, including those cited as evidence for U.S. Department of Education grant competitions, studies that were funded by the department, and studies identified for systematic reviews of evidence based on a search of the research literature in a particular topic area. The WWC also publishes topic area synthesis protocols, which now under version 5.0 of the handbook will provide topic-specific parameters regarding the study identification and study eligibility for reviews under a given topic area. Note that on the WWC website, you can also access protocols used under previous versions of the standards. It is important to acknowledge that under previous versions of the WWC standards, topic area review teams sometimes had the ability to customize certain aspects of the standards, and any such customization was documented in those protocols. However, under version 5.0 of the standards, the handbook and the study review protocol now govern the application of the standards. So newer topic area synthesis protocols will only be used to specify eligibility criteria for interventions, samples, and outcomes relevant for a synthesis product. And they will also provide guidance for literature searches and guidance for prioritizing studies for review. The Resources for Reviewers page contains links to publications that help or reinforce key concepts, including webinars. These webinars provide timely updates on WWC products or may provide technical assistance training for reviewers, researchers, and practitioners. The WWC website also includes a Frequently Asked Questions, or FAQ, site, which includes a list of common questions and answers relevant to the content covered in the training. The WWC's Help Desk is another important resource. The Help Desk responds to inquiries from the public on various topics. You can submit technical questions through the Help Desk about how to access the training, modules, and training resources, or to ask questions about the content covered in the training. Please note, however, that the WWC cannot provide active technical assistance to researchers designing studies, but rather, the WWC can provide support around the WWC training environment or any questions about the content covered in the training. You can find all of these resources on the WWC website, whatworks.ed.gov. For those who want to pursue the optional certification through the WWC, trainees must successfully complete a multiple-choice certification exam that tests knowledge of the standards covered in the training. Anyone who is interested in pursuing certification and becoming a certified WWC reviewer under the Version 5.0 Group Design Standards must complete the training under the Version 5.0 standards. In other words, there is no recertification option for reviewers who were previously certified under version 4.1 of the standards. This is because there have been several significant shifts in the WWC standards and procedures under version 5.0. The WWC recognizes the amount of time and effort it takes trainees to complete these certification exams, so the WWC does offer a pre-test exam for trainees to take. Trainees who pass a section of the pre-test exam can then waive that section on the full certification exam. In order to become certified in the 5.0 standards, trainees must pass all sections of a multiple-choice certification exam, where each section of the exam focuses on a specific area of the group design standards. This certification exam is graded within each section, so if a trainee happens to fail one section of the exam, they only need to reattempt that section of the exam. The WWC allows 4 attempts at passing each section of the exam. This pre-testing option is intended to support those experienced WWC reviewers who are already intimately familiar with the WWC standards under earlier versions of the handbook. Experienced reviewers may wish to take the pre-test without reviewing all of the modules, but new reviewers are advised to view all of the modules before attempting the pre-test or full-length exams. The certification test can be accessed by navigating to the WWC's exam website listed in the slide and on the training website. After becoming a certified reviewer in the WWC Group Design Standards, reviewers can choose to be included in the list of certified reviewers on the WWC website. Certified reviewers who provide their contact information may be contacted to assist with review efforts by organizations that perform reviews in support of WWC activities. Of note, the WWC will contact any certified reviewers if and when there are updates to the WWC standards that may require additional certification activities to maintain one's current reviewer certification. We will conclude this introductory module by providing a summary of what to expect in the group design training series. The content for this training is divided into several modules, all of which follow a consistent structure. Each module includes a summary of the objective for the module, detailed information on the module topic, including examples, and most modules include knowledge checks to reinforce content and test what you have learned. You are currently viewing Module 1 in the training series. After this introductory module, the training consists of 10 additional modules that focus on topics covering the WWC's group design standards and review process. The second module discusses the WWC's process for reviewing evidence from studies. The third module focuses on the types of research designs that we can review using the WWC group design standards, namely randomized controlled trials, or RCTs, and quasi-experimental designs, or QEDs. The fourth module discusses the outcomes a study uses to measure the effectiveness of an intervention and what requirements those outcome measures must meet. This module also discusses confounding factors and discusses how confounding factors affect the WWC's review of a study. The fifth module discusses how units are assigned to conditions in group design studies. This module discusses what counts as an eligible randomized controlled trial, including what the WWC considers well-executed randomization, and what counts as an eligible quasi-experimental design. The sixth module introduces the concept of compositional change, which includes the individual level attrition, cluster level attrition, and cluster level representativeness. This module discusses what compositional change is and why it is important to the WWC. We walk through how to calculate compositional change values and how to apply the WWC standards for compositional change during a study review. The seventh module discusses the concept of baseline equivalence, namely, whether the intervention and comparison groups in a study were similar before the start of an intervention. This module reviews how the WWC defines baseline equivalence and demonstrates when and how to apply the WWC baseline equivalence standard. The eighth module discusses the unique considerations that occur when the WWC reviews evidence from group design studies using repeated measures analysis. The ninth module then discusses additional considerations needed when reviewing evidence from group design studies that have analysis with imputations for missing data. The ninth module discusses effect sizes, which are used to report on the magnitude of the effectiveness of the intervention. The 10th module reviews how the WWC synthesizes findings about and reports on the effectiveness of an intervention. And finally, the 11th module provides an introduction to the online study review guide that certified reviewers use to document findings from a study review. This concludes our introduction to the WWC Group Design Standards training. Let's review what we discussed in this module. We covered the purpose of the training and who should complete the training. We provided background information on the WWC and described logistics related to training. We introduced the Group Design Standards framework and identified resources to support learning the standards. We also discussed the optional reviewer certification process. And finally, provided an overview of the topics we will cover in each module in this training series. Just a few reminders before you proceed. Remember that you can access all of the resources mentioned in this module on the WWC website, whatworks.ed.gov. The full slide deck for this and all training modules is available on the WWC training website, and you can also download or save copies of the training materials. Thank you for viewing this module in the WWC Group Design Standards Training Series.